In the second part of this choral and orchestral concert, there's one work, Philip Cannon's Lord of Light, a Gloucester Requiem, which was commissioned by the Three Choirs Festival and received its first performance at this Three Choirs Festival concert, recorded in Gloucester Cathedral in August 1980. For some years now, Philip Cannon has been drawn to the musical and creative possibilities of the one movement form, which embraces a wide variety of contrasting ideas and emotions. In order to create this unity with the words of the Requiem Mass, he's rearranged the traditional text in Latin, English, French, and German so as to project a continuously unfolding scena or story in a single movement of 12 linked sections. A prophet figure, the baritone, appeals to Christ to save woman and man, the soprano and tenor, from the inexorable judgment of God in punishment for their sins and worldly failings. The chorus, as in a Greek tragedy, describe, explain, and passionately react to the scene, themselves joining in the appeal to God through Christ. Lord of Light ends with a joyful fantasia on one of the Gloucester chimes, Christe Redemptor Omnium. Philip Cannon's Lord of Light, a Gloucester Requiem, is performed now by soprano Iris Dell'Acqua, tenor Kenneth Bowen, and bass Graham Titus, with the Cathedral Choirs of Gloucester, Hereford and Worcester, the Three Choirs Festival Chorus, and the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra, leader Barry Griffiths. The conductor is John Sanders.
Thank you. Go on.
In that first performance of Lord of Light, a Gloucester Requiem by Philip Cannon, the soprano was Iris Dell'acqua, the tenor, Kenneth Bowen, and the bass, Graham Titus. Also taking part were the cathedral choirs of Gloucester, Hereford, and Worcester, and the Free Choirs Festival Chorus, with the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra leader Barry Griffiths. It was recorded in Gloucester Cathedral during the 1983 Choirs Festival, and conducted by John Saunders.